वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स ऑन ऑनलाइन क्लास फॉर सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स फॉर द 12th स्टैंडर्ड. टुडे वी हैव टू लर्न द लास्ट पार्ट इन द चैप्टर नंबर 15, स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम्स एंड न्यूक्लियाई. इन यस्टरडे In last three videos, we have seen the relationship between half-life time period and decay constant. We have also studied the law of radioactive decay or radioactive disintegration. So, we know that some definitions. Number one, we want to remember definition for radioactive element. So question will be asked for 1 mark. What is radioactive element? If the such type of question is asked, then we have a definition such that a substance is one, or it is a substance whose atoms having unstable nuclei, whose atoms having unstable nuclei, such elements are called as radioactive element. Some examples: uranium, lead. So many examples. Such elements can emit the three types of radiation: alpha, beta, and gamma. Such elements are called as radioactive elements. Another definition will be seen. This definition will be a radioactive decay constant. Its symbol like lambda. Sometimes we can use such type of symbol in wavelength. But here we have a constant, and that constant is called as decay constant, that is radioactive decay constant. If a question is asked for 1 mark, define radioactive decay constant. So it is the reciprocal of that time. It is the reciprocal of that time in which number of atoms becomes 1 upon eth of the atoms present initially, called as decay constant. And third, we know the relationship between decay constant and half-life time period. So third definition is also remembered, that is half-life time period. It is the time taken by radioactive substance or substance to disintegrate, to reduce half of initial number of atoms. और हाफ ऑफ नंबर ऑफ एटम प्रेजेंट इनिशियली एंड सच टाइम इज कॉल्ड एज हाफ लाइफ टाइम पीरियड. समटाइम्स इस सिंबल कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड एज टी हाफ और वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट द सिंबल लाइक कैपिटल टी. द रिलेशन बिटवीन दिस कैपिटल टी एंड डीके कॉन्स्टेंट गिव्स ए फॉर्मूला एंड दैट फॉर्मूला इज कैपिटल टी इक्वल टू 0.693 अपॉन लैम्ब्डा और lambda is equal to 0.693 upon capital T and these are the this is the relation between half life time period and decay constant. Today another definition will be seen, that is activity of element. Fourth definition will be activity of element. Activity of element or activity of radioactive element. It is the number of atoms disintegrated per second. Or it is number of decays per unit time is called activity of element. We know that law of disintegration. In this law of disintegration, the rate of disintegration is directly proportional to number of atom present in time t. So this will be dn upon dt is equal to minus lambda n. Dn upon dt is equal to minus lambda n. So we want to determine activity of radioactive element. This radioactive element, it will be using this formula. Lambda is decay constant. Negative sign indicates that when dn upon dt will be increased, n will be decreased. And so that here the activity of element, that will be the ratio. The ratio of disintegration per unit time. The ratio of disintegration per unit time is also called as activity of element. This activity is having unit. The unit of activity is becquerel. The scientist becquerel studies the radioactive elements. This unit becquerel is 1 becquerel is equal to 1 disintegration per second per unit time means per second. Another unit for activity is curie. We know that Marie Curie and Pierre Curie studies radioactivity element and they got a Nobel Prize in their research. So these activity is also measured in fury. So, 1 fury is equal to 3.7 into 10 raised to 10 times becquerel. Or disintegration per second. 1 curie is equal to 3.7 into 10 raised to 10 becquerel. If we can find out millicurie, then here 1 millicurie is 3.7 into 10 raised to 7 becquerel or disintegration per second. If we can say microcurie, millicurie means 10 raised to minus 3 curie and microcurie means 10 raised to minus 6 curie. So 1 microcurie is 3.7 into 10 to the power 4 disintegration per second. There is also a unit. This unit is Rutherford. Yes, becquerel, name of scientist, Curie, name of scientist, and Rutherford, name of scientist. The unit for activity is Rutherford. So, 1 Rutherford is equal to 10 raised to 6 times disintegration per second. So that 1 milli Rutherford. See here. 1 milli Rutherford. It gives 10 raised to 3 disintegration per second. And 1 micro Rutherford, it gives 1 disintegration per second. Means 1 micro Rutherford is equal to 1 disintegration per second. We can also write in this form, that is 1 micro Rutherford is equal to 1 microcurie. See here, 1 micro Rutherford is equal to 1 microcurie is equal to 3.7 into 10 to the power 4 disintegration per second. So, this is the units for activity. Using this definition, we want to study the average life of radioactive element. So, half-life time period, we can also determine. Average life time period can be determined to it. So, first of all, we know that law of disintegration, that is, proves n is equal to n0 e raised to minus lambda t. Then, the total average of number of atom will be dn. That is equal to